Hi, my name is Dr. Dana DiRenzo. It is common for patients with chronic diseases to want to try as many therapies as possible, especially if they are in pain, whether they are prescription therapies from their doctor or complementary and alternative therapies available in the community or over the internet. However, it is always important to talk to your treating physician about all the substances and activities you may take and participate in for your arthritis. The American College of Rheumatology issued a position statement in 2012 recognizing the interests of both patients and physicians in use of complementary and alternative medicines. Generally, in terms of psoriatic arthritis, there are very little scientific studies regarding the effectiveness of complementary and alternative therapies. There is some evidence with regards to herbs, supplements, creams, and mind-body practices for relief of psoriasis. Mahonium aquifolium, also known as Oregon grape. The most common side effects of topical treatment include rash and a burning sensation when applied to the skin. Traditional Chinese herbal medicine. There is some evidence that using TCMs like Chinese foxglove, red sage, purple gromwell, in addition to traditionally prescribed medications and light therapy, may be more effective than conventional treatment alone. On the other hand, patients call in all the time asking about coconut oil in combination with UV light treatment was not found to clear psoriasis plaques faster in the only clinical trial it was studied in. Side effects with combination therapy may include GI upset, elevated liver enzymes, and elevated cholesterol. Patients frequently drink green tea, which contains caffeine, which may improve mental alertness. However, there are no clinical trials to date assessing the effectiveness of green tea for treating psoriasis or psoriatic arthritis. Liver toxicity has been reported if you are drinking large quantities of green tea, but green tea is generally safe. Kombucha tea, this popular drink commonly sold in health stores, is produced by fermenting the kombucha mushroom in tea and sugar. However, there are no scientific studies published with regards to proven health benefits in psoriasis or psoriatic arthritis. There are rare serious side effects from drinking large quantities of this beverage, including impaired liver function, especially for patients with pre-existing liver damage. Other effects include allergic reactions and nausea and vomiting. As a side note, if you are on medications that are processed through your liver, such as methotrexate, it is always important to keep in mind herbs and supplements that may affect your liver. Patients also frequently ask about turmeric, ginger, cinnamon. There is very little evidence that turmeric is effective for psoriasis specifically, but it is known to have anti-inflammatory properties in other diseases. Patients should use caution with long-term use and at high doses, and thus may cause gastrointestinal upset. Ginger, also frequently used, ginger has not been studied in psoriasis or psoriatic arthritis specifically, but has been shown to help with nausea that some patients may experience while taking methotrexate. In terms of ginger, caution should be noted with patients with gallstone disease, as ginger may increase the flow of bile, and for those on blood thinners, there's an unclear certainty of drug interaction. Cinnamon is frequently asked about. There are no clinical trials evaluating cinnamon for psoriasis specifically. There are a small number of trials in mice that have found anti-inflammatory properties of cinnamon, however. Cinnamon contains coumarin, which may cause impaired liver function and should be used with caution, especially if you are prescribed an arthritis medication that is metabolized in the liver. These medications not only include methotrexate, but also include leflunomide and sulfasalazine. Other common supplements include glucosamine and chondroitin and bovine collagen. There is one small published case series that reports improved plaque psoriasis after taking chondroitin supplements. There is no specific study in psoriatic arthritis. However, we know from the osteoarthritis literature that this has proven benefit, especially with patients with knee OA who are having moderate to severe pain. Other substances, such as bovine collagen, which could be topical or oral, have very limited scientific backing. There has been some very serious allergic reactions reported. A word of caution about other potentially used herbs and supplements. St. John's wort. Historically, this has been used to treat depression, anxiety, sleep disorders, and nerve pain. However, there is potential drug interactions with immunosuppressant medications, such as cyclosporine, which is commonly used in psoriasis. Ginseng, particularly in Asian patients, ginseng may alter the ability of the body to metabolize certain drugs. Examples of these drugs include tacrolimus and colchicine, other drugs that are commonly used in the rheumatology division. So in conclusion, remember, herbs and supplements, which are tried by nearly 50% of patients with psoriasis and psoriatic arthritis, are not bound by proven quality standards that all prescription medications approved by the FDA have. Herbs and supplements may still contain very powerful ingredients that can alter your immune system and the way your body processes medications. Natural substances do not necessarily mean safer substances or substances with less side effects. We are here to help and are open to discussing all of the herbs and supplements that you may be taking or are interested in. Complementary therapy should never be used in place of your prescription medications. It is also important for us to know about the herbs and supplements you may take because they may interact with your prescribed medications. Please talk to your doctor about questions or concerns that you may have regarding alternative therapies. A great resource for specific information on any herb or supplement can be found at the National Center for Complementary and Integrative Health.